Dreamed of creating and selling your own ebooks, courses, digital downloads, and more? There are so many barriers to starting, such as how to promote your products and what kind of payment gateways you could use. With Notion's new sites feature, it couldn't be easier to start your own website that could act as your store's landing page. In this video, we wanted to guide you step by step and give you a Notion tour of our store landing page website Notion template. If you find this video useful, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. Let's first start with a preview of what your store landing page could look like. So as you can see, everything is very easy to navigate. For example, on the top, we have About Me, Courses, Blog, Portfolio, and Contact. And this is an example for a photography school that sells courses. But of course, this would apply no matter what kind of thing you're trying to sell. And here we have a short bio and a call to action button to go immediately to the course offerings. And then here we have a free course that people can download directly from the landing page. Under here, we put testimonials that you can also embed to show to your potential customers that the course has helped them or your product has helped them, as well as footer links below. And we also have various pages such as About Me, Courses, and this can also be your store, Blog, Portfolio, and a contacts page. And all of these pages are connected to a return home button so everyone can easily navigate across your web page. Now let's talk about how to completely customize this store landing page template to make it yours and for your unique product and services. So the first thing you'll want to do is to change the name here so you can add your business name here. If you have, for example, a logo or an icon you want to upload, you can also click here, add icon, and choose any of these icons here or through Notion's own icons, or you can also upload a custom file. The next thing you can do is go to change cover and also change up the look here. So you can obviously upload your own images. You can also upload links and you can also use Unsplash, which is a huge stock image library. After that, in the home page, you'll want to edit your welcome message. So here you can add a short bio to introduce people to what you do. And under here, we recommend you to add some kind of free offer or something very enticing for your customers when they first land to your page. But of course, you can also edit this part however you wish. We'll be showing you our payment gateway options later on in this video. And then under here, you can also embed testimonials, which we'll also cover a bit later in this video. And on the bottom, we have footer links. So these are entirely optional, but they are synced across all of the pages. So if you wanted to add a link here, you can simply add the link by clicking add link, and you can add your unique link here. We would recommend you to retype the link, for example, such as privacy policy, and then highlighting it and then linking so that the text actually gets linked. The other thing you can edit are these follow me here areas. So again, make sure to type out the word you want for the name of the link, and then you can add link. Another thing to make sure to do is to replace this photo with your own photo or some kind of mood picture. If you go to the three dots here and then go to replace, you'll be able to replace it with any picture you wish. So now let's go ahead and go to the About Me section. So in the About Me section, you can basically fill in all of your information here. And here in the company name, if you want to link out to an external source, you can highlight this and then you can link here, add link, and change the link title as well. We also have a place for recognition and awards, a timeline of your life, interviews and features. And again, this one is synced across all of the pages, so you just need to change it once. The follow me here is also synced, so you can also edit these as you wish. And all of these headings and text, all of this can be edited the way that you want. So you don't have to use this format. We just added it here in case you want something to start with. Next, let's go into the portfolio section. So here we have, for example, in this case, since it's a photography example, we put a portfolio, for example, wedding photography, monochrome photography, nature photography. But of course, you can also add any kind of system you want with your portfolio, depending on your unique business. So if you want to add a new portfolio, you can click plus new and then title it and add a cover photo here that's going to show up here. And if, for example, Inside of the portfolio, you want to add more pictures. You can type /image and then add an image through here. So if this was a nature photography portfolio, you might want to add more images of your nature photography and showcase that here. If you're more into sort of a language learning or other kinds of business niches, you could put examples of what kind of services you've offered in the past or what kind of companies you've worked for and so on. So the portfolio section is very flexible. If you don't need the portfolio section, you can also delete it from the front page. So if we go here, any of the pages you don't need, you can actually just delete them. The next thing we wanted to cover is the blog section. So if we click the blog here, you'll notice that we have these areas you can have articles. So if you wanted to add a new one, you would just could plus new. You can add a cover photo that represents the topic of your article. And then you could have your article here, your date that you're going to post it, and then any tags. So if it's a personal article, you could put personal and so on. And then you can start typing in here. So for example, heading 3, title. And then you would put your text down here. So this is all as you wish, how you want to format it. And all of your new articles are going to appear at the front here based on the sorting. So now let's talk about the payment gateways and how you're actually going to add a payment system, download system, whatever kind of product you're trying to sell, how you're going to actually implement that into your Notion site. So we have several options here and we'll be going through each of them. They are Gumroad, Tally, Typeform, and Lemon Squeezy. And mainly these are for digital downloads. So if you have a PDF that you want to sell, or a course, or a Notion template even, or you want to redirect them to a special link, all of these can work for you. So the first option we wanted to introduce to you is Gumroad. And for a really long time, we used Gumroad as our own payment gateway. So we know this platform very well, and it's a really great starting point for those who want to sell digital products. So if you wanted to add a Gumroad product to your Notion site, how we would recommend you to do it is, for example, if you're on your page here for all of your products, and then you go to a specific product such as this simple book tracker, we would copy this link. We would copy the link to this page, and then if we go back to our Notion, we can paste this in, and then what we can do is instead of layout equals profile, we would do price equals 0 and wanted equals true. And this takes them immediately to the checkout page. And we found that if you embed only the single product, it doesn't work so well in this web page. So we're just going to add that in, and then we can copy. And then we can paste that link in, embed link. So this is kind of what it would look like in that case. It would just take them directly to the checkout page so that they can enter their email address and get the product. Obviously, this doesn't look the nicest option. So some of our other options, as we showed in the preview, is Lemon Squeezy. We personally haven't used it as our own payment gateway, but it does look the best in terms of embedding. So we're going to show you Lemon Squeezy next. So in Lemon Squeezy, if you have a product, you can go to the share button here. So let's say we want to share the landscape photography for beginners course. And then what we would do is we would go to the checkout link, and you can remove, for example, the store logo. You can remove product description, discount codes, and so on, and then copy. So now if we go back to our Notion page, we can paste that in as an embed, and it would look something like this. So we think that this looks the best in terms of embedding. The other options, if you only have, for example, one product, or you want to accept payments in another way, what we would recommend you to do is to try Tally or Typeform. So here we have, for example, in Tally, a landscape photography for beginners course, where you can actually purchase it through here, and you can put your name, address, and then if you connect it with Stripe, then you should be able to accept payments. So this is another option if you want to embed this in. And We won't go into the details of these form builders because it can get quite complicated, but we really recommend you to try all of these out. The same thing for Typeform. You can also add payment information like this and connect it with Stripe. And at the end, you can have a link to the file download after the payment is complete. So this is another way to handle payments and digital downloads. And same for Tally, you could add the link to download when they have successfully submitted their payment. So next, let's actually go to the store page. So just like we did in the front page, we basically embedded the Lemon Squeezy link here. And all you have to do is reshape it like this. And you can describe your product like this. If this is a course, you might want to describe each module. If it's something else, you might want to also put some kind of descriptive here. If, for example, you wanted to add a full page store, this would work, for example, with a Gumroad embed. So we're just going to show you real quick with Gumroad. So if we go slash embed, and now we have an embed slot here, and we go to Gumroad. If we go to our entire store page here, and we linked the store page into our Notion like this, then we can pull this down and potentially showcase our entire store on this page as well. So this is another option if you have something like Gumroad, which is already sort of a storefront page that you want to add to a landing page. This could also be another option. And finally, we also added the option if you want someone to send you a direct message for one-to-one instruction, we have a button here that's going to connect you to the contact page. So now that we're in the contact page, let's go ahead and discuss how to make a contact form. So in this case, we also recommend Tally, and above all the other form options, Tally is also free to use, which is nice. So if you use Typeform, you're limited to a number of responses. So we could recommend Tally. Also, it looks quite nice inside of Notion pages. So here, if you're in Tally's workspace, you can go to templates over here. And let's say that you want this simple contact form. So we would recommend you to click this, then you can click use this template. And it gets automatically loaded into your account, and all you would have to do is hit publish and copy the link. So again, there's a lot you can do to customize this, but if you really just want a simple contact form, this is a really great option. Then you go to Notion and then you paste it in. So now if we go back home, we now have our free course offering here, and we also included the contact page. So the next thing we wanted to show you is how the button works. So basically this button connects to your store page. So if we click here, it goes directly to the store. Then we can go back home. If you want to edit the text for this button, you can click this and then change the text here. Now we wanted to show you Senja, which is a testimonial tool. So the thing that we would recommend to embed here would be from Senja. So here for in Senja, all you would need to do is sign up for free, and it's free up to 15 testimonials. And as you can see, we have here our testimonials page, and we can easily go to Studio to create a widget for this. Then we could go to widgets, and then we can choose something like this testimonial masonry. And we're going to be adding this to the homepage, and we can create widget. So once you have a widget like this, you simply go to share and then go to URL, copy this URL, and then you can go to your Notion, embed. And then you would drag this down so that everything gets shown. And this is just a really great way to highlight that your product is really useful for other people and just to show some credibility. And if we go to testimonials, we can also embed the same link here and drag it down. And it's really easy to also collect testimonials with Senja, so we highly recommend you to just give it a try for free. So now that we're back in our homepage, the next thing we're going to show you is how to publish this website to the web. So if we go to share button here and then go to publish, then you can hit publish and you already get a Notion site like this with a link. And you can choose to search engine index or not, and you can also set link expiration. But in this case, we would recommend you to turn on the search engine indexing. And then what you can do is also edit the link title description for the SEO. The next thing you'll want to do is go to site customization. Inside site customization, you can do things like change it to dark mode or light mode, or based on the system that the person is looking at it from. You can change the favicon icon to your own image. And then you can also add Google Analytics here like this. And you can also change a lot of things in the header. So if we go to the header, the first thing you have the option is whether or not you want to show breadcrumbs or not show breadcrumbs, the search, duplicate as template, and the Notion watermark is going to be only disabled on custom domains. So we would recommend you to at least turn off the duplicate as template if this is a public web page. And then the other thing you'd want to do is to add pages to the top that's going to act as your navigation bar. So the first thing we would add is the store, the blog, the about me, the contact, and the portfolio. So unfortunately, there's a maximum of 5 page shortcuts, so make sure to choose the ones that make the most sense for you here. But any additional pages can also be added into the navigation bar. And you can also reorder them like this, for example. And then you can hit publish changes. So you can go to site settings and then go to this here, manage all domains. Once you're in this page, what you can do is to add a new domain. And if you want to add a custom domain, it is $10 a month, but it can be a really great way to really personalize your landing page to make sure that it really looks like your brand. So once all the settings are good, then you can go ahead and copy the site link. And this is basically what your page could look like. Thank you so much for watching. If you're interested in the template, we'll leave the link to it in the description below. All our third-party tool recommendations are also in the description. Let us know if you have any questions or comments, and we hope to see you all in the next video.